Let's do some questions based on cube roots and square roots, squares and cubes. So now we have the question number 1, which says we have to find out the cube of 0.1. So how do we find out the cubes? We multiply the same number 3 times with itself, that is 0.1 into 0.1 into 0.1. You would get 1 with 3 decimal places. So you have got 0.001 as the cube of 0.1. Next is that you have to find the cube root. Now for finding the cube root, we will write the cube root of 1331. And as I discussed with you before, how to find the cube root, we will have to find the factors first. So let us find out the factors for 1331. That would go with 11. And we get 11. 11 into 11 into 11 as the factors for 1331. So we write them in the cube root and we start grouping them now. On grouping, we found that we have only 11. So 11 becomes the cube root of 1331. You can check your answer by multiplying 11 with itself 3 times, that is 11 into 11 into 11. You're going to get back this 1331. Next part of this question is where you have to find the cube root of 3375 over 4096. Now for finding the cube root of fractions, you take the cube root of numerator separately and you do the cube root of denominator separately. By doing that, you will get the cube roots of numerator and denominator separate and you put them in the ratio form, you would get your answer. So 3375 cube root will go with 5, 56 as 30, 57 as 35, 55 as 25, 51 as 5, 53 as 15, 16, 17, 55 as 25, 52 as 10, and 35, 57 as 35, 39 as 27, 33 as 9, and 31 as 3. So we get the numerator as under root, the cube root over here. We get 3 into 3 into 3 into 5 into 5 into 5. Let's do it for the denominator, that is 4096. Start with 2. 2 2s are 4. And this 2 1 2 4 2 5 1 2. 2 times 2 5 6. Then 2 1 2 2s are 4. 2 8s are 16. 2 6 are 12, 2 4 are 8, 2 3 are 6, 2 2 are 4, 2 1 are 2, 2 6 are 12, 2 8 are 16, 2 4 are 8, 2 2 are 4. So we have got the factors for 4096 also. We are going to arrange them inside the cube root. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. How many times? 6 times. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. Now we have written down all the factors, right? And they are in the numerator upon denominator form. So now we are going to group them together. For grouping, we start the numbers. And we have grouped them into 3 because we were finding the cube roots. So we get the numerator as 3 into 5 and denominator as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. The numerator becomes 15 and denominator becomes 16. So this is the cube root of under root of and the cube root of 3375 upon 4096. Next question is, you have to find the square. So how to find the square? We multiply the same number with itself 2 times, that is 0.15 into 0.15. Let us do the multiplication. 15 into 15, 5 5s are 25, 2 5 ones are 5, 6 7, 1 5 is 5 and 1, 7 8 9 10 11 12, and 1, you get 225. So here you are going to get 225, but with 4 decimal places, 3 are already there. You put another 0 and put a decimal place, and so you have got the square of 0.15. Next is finding the square root. Now for finding the square root, again we are going to do the same thing as we did for the cube root of the fraction. That is, we are going to write cube root of 169 over 196. And we are going to separate the cube roots for both numerator and denominator. And we get this. What do I get as the cube root of 169? Here we were doing the square root. So do not make such mistakes where you have written down cube root, because here you are finding out the square root, but if you write down this cube root again, you will end up doing the same wrong mistake, that is, you will end up doing the cube root. So please be very careful when you are finding out the squares, cubes, square roots and cube roots. Here we were supposed to find out only the square root. So we know directly, very simple, we will do the factorization of 169. We will do it with, you can check it with any number. 9 plus 1 is 10, 10 plus 6 is 16. I know that 13, 13 is 169, right? So you can even check it on your own by multiplying 13 and 13. 3 3s are 9, 3 1s are 3, 1 3s are 3 and 1. So you get 169. I know the direct values. That means for you, you have to learn some squares and some cubes of, let's say, first 15 to 20 numbers. That will reduce your task of calculation for this chapter. So now you have 13 upon, and 196 is for 14 probably. Let us check. 4 4s are 16, 1. 4 1s are 4, 5. 4, 1, 6, 9, and 1. As I guessed, it is 13 upon 14. And so we have got the square root of 169 upon 196 as 13 upon 14. Now the fifth part is a bit different one. Here you have to evaluate this expression. So first of all, let us write this down, that the expression given to us is under root of 25 minus under root of 16 whole upon under root of 49 plus under root of 9. As we have discussed earlier, this root represents the square root, and square root value we are very much familiar. What will be the square root of 25? It is going to be 5, because 5 multiplied with itself gives you 25. And similarly, minus, what will be the square root of 16? That will be 4. Square root of 49, 7. Square root of 9, 3. So we get 5 minus 4, 1. 7 plus 3, 10. 1 by 10 as the answer for this evaluation. The last one is where we have to evaluate the values for these. Here, question number 6, first part. You can check that minus 1 is the base having power 27. Now, can you actually do it? You will have to write minus 1 27 times and multiply it. Is it possible? No, that is possible, but you will take a lot of time. So, I'll tell you the easier trick. Whenever any such question comes, always check the power. Here the power is written 27. That means this is odd power, right? Because 27 is odd. For odd powers, if you have a minus sign in between, in the value, in the base, your answer is going to have a minus sign for odd powers only. And if you know very well, 1 multiplied even 1000 times will give you 1 only. So you will write 1 here. So that is the quick way of doing this question, right? Next type is where you have to evaluate this value. So let us write this down. Minus 3 by 4 whole raised to power 4. Now this means you have to multiply minus 3 by 4 how many times? 4 times. So we write this down 4 times and we have to multiply. Because the power was even, we know, and if the base is having minus sign, that means the answer that is going to be will have a positive sign. I have discussed both cases. When the power is odd, your answer is going to have a negative sign if the base is negative. If the base is negative and power is even, your answer is going to be positive. And the values multiplied, 3 3s are 9 and this 3 3s are also 9. So you get 9 into 9, 81. 4 4s are 16 and 4 4s are 16. So let's do 16 into 16. 6 6 are 36, 3 6 1s are 6, 7 8 9, 6 and 1, 6, you get 15, 2. So you get 256. So the answer for this evaluation is plus 81 upon 256, and there it was minus 1. Whenever you are evaluating powers, please be careful whether the power is odd or even, if the base is having some negative sign. If this is the case, you can directly identify that your answer is going to have a negative sign or not. If the power is odd, your answer is going to have a negative sign as the base had, and as the base is having negative sign and power is even, the answer is not going to have negative sign, it will have a positive sign.